Thanks for watching the Daily Debate live here on Nile TV International. I'm Tagrid Hussein, and I have the pleasure of your company for the coming hour on the debate tonight. A very interesting topic. We're talking about how to improve Egypt's image on the international level. A very important topic that comes actually timing while we are asking all Egyptians to invest in our soft power. And the soft power, by the soft power, we mean culturally, we mean historically, and also scientifically. It's a step on the right path. The president took the initiative by holding an important meeting and giving directives in that respect, discussing means of enhancing also contacts with Egyptians, Egyptian expats living abroad, our ambassadors abroad, and benefiting also from their ideas and their different proposals. How can we think out of the box in that direction of improving the country's image? Well, the latest efforts to combat terrorism are also there, while we are reading more than one important headline like the Brussels attacks, and comes here also the necessity of renewing the religious discourse. We have with us a very important panel and a distinctive panelist to talk about this important issue. We have with us Excellency Mr. Yahia, Negm, political analyst. Thank you very much, Mr. Negm, for being here.
Much.
And I thank very much Mr. Walid Batouty, Egyptologist in the first place and WFTGA representative for the Middle East and North Africa. Gentlemen, thank you very much for coming to the debate tonight.
Thank you.
Well, first let's see a report highlighting how to improve Egypt's image, the directives that came there in the presidential meeting, and we'll be back.
Intellectuals on Tuesday, marking the start of a national dialogue between the government and prominent thinkers from various political currents. Tuesday meeting, the first in a series of regular meetings scheduled for the coming months, aimed at facilitating an exchange of ideas and visions for progression in the country. The three-hour meeting was held at the presidential palace and was attended by 24 notable intellectuals. Among those present were columnist Abdullah Assinawi, screenwriter Wahid Hamid, Islamic scholar Yusuf Zidane, and novelist Ibrahim Abdelmajid. The meeting covered issues currently facing the country, including the topics of human rights and freedoms, the status of prisoners, the situation of the media and economy. The participants broached the subject of the Egyptian media, which they believe falls short on providing citizens with the truth. Ways to regulate and improve media services were discussed. According to Al Ahram newspaper, the president responded to questions on the current economic problems facing Egypt and the region.
We're back. We're discussing how to improve Egypt's image. Mr. Negm, talking about improving Egypt's image abroad. This is actually a very noble target, and it comes timely. So we're talking about working on that target. What does it entail, and the significance of the state, the political will now behind this important target?
Yes, of course, it's a noble target and long-awaited one as well. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's a big task for us in the time being. In the moment, we have suffered a lot of hits against our image and against our tourism all over the world. Mm-hmm. Terrorism, instability, of course, political situation in Egypt as well. So we had the whole situation in the Middle East indeed is a very chaotic right now. So we need a lot. First, not only to solve the problem of our image as Egypt, but to solve the problem of the Middle East as a whole, the image of the Middle East, the image of Arabs, the image of Muslims, and then the image of Egyptians or Egypt. So it's very complicated and needs a lot of work and a lot of efforts and new ideas, of course. So we have to think in all these axes to resolve the problem. It's not about mm-hmm. to contract a public relation yeah. campaign mm-hmm. or a public relation company to do this. We mm-hmm. have to do this ourselves. Of course, maybe we can use some of these companies, but the main job and the main target is ours. So we have to start with the reforms inside before talking about the external world. We have to some tasks here to we have to reform our political system. We have to reform our services. We have to reform, of course, the problem of security inside Egypt and the services. Also, culturally, we have to teach our people how to treat the others, how to accept them, how to talk to them with their own language. I don't refer to English or French, but I refer to their also the common values and the common principles between the East and West. So we have a lot of to do in, of course, the media should play a very important role in this to explain what's happening in Egypt for foreigners and to explain to Egyptians as well what's going on outside, what's going on in our region. So we can, we should have answers and we should take measures to reform all our aspects. So also maybe a campaign against corruption, against bad treatment to the tourists. We have to learn all of this to compete. We have a very strong competition with Spain, Turkey, many important countries in the Mediterranean at least. So they receive a lot of tourism and maybe their economic situation, their political situation is better than ours. But we have to do, because our potential is greater than theirs or than what's happening right now for us. Our potential is very high in tourism and to refurbish our image in the outside world. So it's a long task. All authorities and all ministries in Egypt should do something. Every one of them has a role. Education has a role. Media has a role. Even the health sector has a role. So we have to integrate our efforts together to play this symphony to improve the image outside.
Right. Mr. Batouty, talking about playing the symphony, we cannot play it except together. You, as an Egyptologist, you know quite well how to invest in what we call Egypt's soft power, historically and culturally and scientifically. So, which is the best way to address the other through investing in our soft power?
First of all, I think we should put a target and then play with the necessary tools. Number one, I do not bring someone who is not known to the West and put him to speak to them. First of all, I need to put someone that they know. If I can use names, I can think of Dr. Zahi Hawass, I can think of Sir Jacob Magdi Aoub. These are the people are already known to the West. So we can open a gate through them. Let me use an example, for example, if I may say, the Pope Tawadros of Egypt, when he went to Luxor, immediately this have hit, and he went into the tomb of King Tut. And we already have Professor Reeves was talking about a new discovery in Valley of the Kings. And then here we go, we have the Pope on a visit to Upper Egypt, and of course he is an Egyptian, and they're going to take him on a tour, and we've used that picture. Right, so abroad, we have very successful examples. For example, I always like to use life examples. I have a friend of mine who teaches tourism in a university in Vienna, Mohammed. His name is Mohammed Farouk. He teaches tourism to the people in Vienna. Why can't we use him over there? Why can't we start using our people, the Egyptian football players who they are, you know, every day they're making a great success. These are the people that will make a little advert about Egypt or, you know, come out of the love of Egypt and say, I'm going for my vacation and follow me on my Facebook when I go to Egypt. And he comes and spend a couple of days in Sharm, maybe goes to Siwa. Let's open a new places. And the project that we need to do, we need the 90 million to be participants in it. We need all the people of Egypt, not the people that works in the sector of tourism, and the people that benefit from tourism, because see, everyone in Egypt benefits from tourism.
You know, a doctor reflects on the economy, so everybody benefits.
Yes, the doctor that works in a hospital, the dollars that comes for the machinery that he uses
keeps
for the
life on moving. Yeah.
So we've been tackling the West for $1 billion when tourism used to give us $14 billion easy, and tourism gave us $14 billion in 2010. We lost, as they say, we lost $70 billion in the past 5 years. Do we want them back? If we want them back, those 70, it's never too late. We still can make it, but we need to hold a national project. We need to have everyone to understand that a smile can do.
Yeah,
when you see a tourist, just smile, right? It doesn't hurt you to the
That's a culture of awareness that we
tissue,
need to
put the tissue in your pocket. You don't have to throw it in the street. Let's have a general campaign go through all over the country. I remember when I was a little kid, we used to have an advert on television about close the water, because it will, the drop of water will cause this. Why not? Even it's an old idea. Why don't we use things like this? And, you know, see how old I am now, but I still remember it since I was 7 years old. That's for the from the time the TV was black and white.
It has an impact.
All of us probably. I mean, you're probably younger than me, but I don't know if you've seen this advert or not, but I remember it very well. Things like this, we should educate the kids not to throw a tissue in the street, not to throw the can of a Coke in the street, right? And smile when you see a tourist. Let's consider it as a mission for every Egyptian and assign everybody, you're responsible for this. And if you may allow me, I'm just going to say quickly, I had a tour last week, and we were cruising the Nile in a small type of boat that's called the Dahabiyas, and passing by a little island in the middle of the Nile, and we're too far away from the kids. And all the kids just jumped and start saying, hello, hello, hello. I said to the tourists, immediately reply to them, because that's what keeps them going.
Yeah.
If they don't see people.
This is a sense of communication. Well, in the sense of communication on the official level, Mr. Negm, the Egyptian diplomacy had succeeded actually in building bridges with different countries. How is the popular diplomacy working hand in hand with state diplomacy in that respect to improve the image?
Well, as well, it's a very important role also for our diplomacy to be effective and active in this aspect. Of course, the official diplomacy, we should talk to new sectors and the outside world, not to communicate only with the Minister of Foreign Affairs and in other countries, but we have to talk to other sectors, universities, groups of businessmen and syndicates, maybe. All these, all people, retired people, they are very keen to travel. They lived their life without maybe enjoying it, and now they are retired and they want to go to see the world. So we have to talk to all these new sectors to attract this kind of tourism to Egypt. We have to talk to the think tanks, groups even of human rights. We have to talk to all these people to convince them
that civil society members,
to convince them that what we have is not a very deep problem, it's maybe a passing problem. The tourism is not one of our characteristics. We are very tolerant people. We receive people with, as my colleague said, with a smile, with a hug maybe. So they would feel secure to come and feel confident to visit Egypt and to spend some time. Even individuals, here, we, every one of us should talk to, and this is maybe the popular diplomacy, every one of us should talk to his friends outside and to show them some photos, some videos about Egypt, the tourism, the hospitality of the Egyptian people and so on, the new projects. Give them hope and give tell them that Egypt is, this is a temporary thing by passing all over the world, not only in Egypt, maybe the whole Middle East. It's not our fault, it's not our problem, and we will go through this and we will overcome all these obstacles against our image and our freedom, our tourism. Mm-hmm. So we have to talk to them. Popular tourism as well. Businessmen should do more to to attract, to maybe invite some others, their colleague for conferences in Egypt. Doctors should invite other medical conferences here. Mm-hmm. So everybody, I believe, should make an effort. Mm-hmm. We can, and now the prices are very low. The Egyptian pound is not in his in its best situation right now. Mm-hmm. So the industry is very welcoming this kind of efforts. Hotels are very cheap right now. Transport is cheap. Mm-hmm. So we have
seized the opportunity
mm-hmm. to give them more incentives to come to Egypt.
Right. From what Mr. Negm is saying, Mr. Walid, concerning this culture of hope that we need to invest, it's very important, you know, how to optimize in itself is very important in bringing people and extending bridges of communication. And nations around the world are now working on what we call nation branding, which is making use of one of the powerful elements of public cultural diplomacy. Where are we from that today?
We're too far away. We're not that far. We still can work.
What we are doing, actually.
We unfortunately, we wasted a good 5 years that we could have done a lot, mm-hmm. But it's never too late. Mm-hmm. If we can spread the hope again and work on, for example, we went and spent $69 million, which is equivalent of $500 million Egyptian pounds, with an advertising company that was supposed to advertise Egypt and do public relation abroad mm-hmm. and stuff like this. I, from my humble point of view, I would say we could have taken this money and spent it on the infrastructure and training the people of Egypt that we have lost the good candidates.
Mm. The fresh public relations approach is also needed, because we need that aspect as well, right?
Absolutely. Mm. But what I'm saying is the news travel, mm-hmm. if we clean up the pyramid area.
Do we need to change the concept in the way that we are marketing Egypt, the 100%. Approach itself?
100%. Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. We have a problem. A lot of people in Egypt think that when I speak English, then the West will understand me. No. Mm. If you don't understand his culture, if you don't speak his tongue, if you don't speak his mentality, forget it.
Mm-hmm. You need to address his brains.
Absolutely. Mm. And we need to talk their language. If you're talking to Americans, you have to speak their language with their understanding. Mm. If you're talking to, for example, you have people, they approach a tourist family are visiting Egypt, mm. and they have a little kid with them, and then they go and touch the kid and play with his hair and maybe hug him and kiss him, you know, and this drives the others crazy. I mean, what is this?
They might be offended. Yeah,
they will be offended because unless, you know, this is the rule of tour guides, immediately they try to explain to the people, you know, Egyptians are very friendly, a very touchy nation. I mean, you just prepare them a little bit to make them a little bit accept, but sometimes people, they don't want to accept that, you know. So
that's why we need to understand.
Yes, mm-hmm. and they have their own people over here that their mission mm-hmm. is also to take bad news, because mm-hmm. bad news makes news, good news doesn't make news. Mm-hmm. So their people with their concept that we always see them that against Egypt. No, they're not that against Egypt. He's doing his job. He gets paid to bring bad things out of Egypt. So we have to change our addressing on every Friday prayer, mm-hmm. the Islam.
That's why the religious discourse is definitely
we've been talking about it. In my opinion, we've been mm-hmm. talking about it, but we did not bring people who speak perfect English mm-hmm. With perfect manners, and then they explain to the West that mm-hmm. Islam is a religion of peace. Let me tell you something. When Obama came and visited Egypt, mm-hmm. they took him to Sultan Hassan's mosque. And people were wondering, oh, why they didn't take him to the Muhammad Ali? There is more colors and things like this. Mm. You know what? It was a very smart move. They took Obama to that mosque to show him that the four sects of Islam, the four schools of Islam, when they call for the prayer, they pray behind anyone. So that
was
made him understand a message that Islam knew democracy way long time ago.
Mm, right.
You're delivering a message. Mm-hmm. Okay.
A message by example.
Okay. Mm. So, and there was a woman in the mosque, leading the leader of the world, and she was explaining to him inside the mosque. Mm. I mean, there is hidden messages that was done.
Mm. How Islam also respects women and women rights in Islam. More and more messages, you know.
There is a lot of things needs to be explained. There is a lot of stories that it's said about us in the West. Mm. And we're not defending it. You know, we're leading, other people are saying, for example, we did not defend the word ISIS. You know, they keep saying the fundamental group that is doing all these crises, mm-hmm. ISIS. You know, we have to...
But we don't use this term, by the way, in our...
We use ISIL, but we did not lead a campaign saying, no, wait a minute, ISIS is a goddess of love. ISIS is a goddess of magic.
This is promoting ISIS in a different story, an Egyptian pharaonic amazing story.
You know, so we could take it from there.
Yeah, right.
We could use our...
Unconventional way of, like, knocking doors.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. We should stop the... And I've been saying this, me and a friend of mine, Mr. Akram Allam, who we travel abroad and give lectures about Egypt. We've been saying, stop the willing dervish, they have seen it. Stop the belly dancing, they have seen it. Mm-hmm. Just before coming in the studio, a friend of mine called me from Inna. And he says, please, on air, say that they should have not taken the belly dancer to the, there was a convention.
To the Berlin?
No, there was one in Russia yesterday. A tourism
anyhow, morning. they are interested also in our culture. This doesn't mean that they do not want to see belly dancing, but there is more that could be provided other than that.
Year after year, you're not taking a new thing. Mm. You know, I said, for example, there is a guy in Luxor. Mm-hmm. I'm just using an example. He never went to art school. This guy never went to art school. He takes a little piece of limestone and with his hand. You know, this guy, Ahmed, he was raised, and the tomb of Ramoza, it was his house. So he memorized every scene in the tomb, you know, from his heart.
Yeah.
And he draws it. By the time we go and visit the tomb and we come out, it's a piece from the wall. He carved it with a little screwdriver. And
so examples and masterpieces actually presented in them. Mr. Negm, well, more than one example, as Mr. Walid was saying, like presence by example and presenting unconventional ways is always important. Yes. Well, the media also has a very important role to play. What else?
Well, we have to go in strategic alliances with new also countries. All our friends in the outside world, we should intensify our relations with them. As I said before, groups and new states, we have to go maybe...
And friendship associations. We do have like diplomatic friends associations all over the world.
Exactly.
How are those? How are we working in collaboration?
Yes, maybe to go to Asia more. The Asian market is promising, and we did not seize the potential of Asia, China, Russia, maybe once again, because they suffered as well as us from the terrorism. So they understand the problem, and their economy also suffers from the sanctions and the problems of terrorism as ours. So they would understand, they would, of course, with some security measures in the airports, they would resume their tourism to Egypt, the Russian, the Chinese, the African maybe. It's very new and unconventional market for them. But of course, there are some rich Africans who would like to visit Egypt, and they know about Egypt, and they know about the Egyptian civilization as one of the most ancient African civilizations. Mm-hmm. So some of them, yes, they would like to come. Some of them would like to invest in Egypt. Some of them would like to trade with Egypt in some products. Of course, in the place of Dubai, in place of going to Dubai to buy some things, why not coming to buy it from Egypt if we take some measures to also activate the purchasing tourism to make it Egypt
provide incentives.
Yes, incentives and open markets for commodities. To instead of going to Dubai, instead of going to Singapore, Egypt is nearer for them. Of course, for example, South Africa. South Africa is one of the richest countries in the continent. So many also tourists from there would like also to come in their even way to Europe or their way to Asia. Mm-hmm. Egypt is in the middle. So we have to make some nets of friendship and yeah. alliances mm. with tourism companies, with the tourism association, with the friendship association, with the new groups, as we said, of retired people and rich countries like maybe South Africa, India, China. All these Asian markets are still new, and we did not see the opportunity with them yet.
Right. Well, more opportunities should be seized, Mr. Walid, talking about the opportunities that we need to unleash. There are other potential and different nations that we have not addressed yet. Mr. Negm is talking about Asia and talking about the African market. Everybody is interested in Africa today. China is interested in Africa. And is the approach different here when we are speaking and addressing those countries and in a way or another?
Yes, in a way. You know, don't forget that Egypt was the leading country in Africa.
Right.
There is still some schools in Ethiopia with the name of Gamal Abdel Nasser.
Yeah.
You know, it was the pearl of Africa. So, we can get this back. And nevertheless, we don't want to also lose what we had before, saying that, okay, if you're not coming, I will go on this direction. Number one, I would like to say something, but number one, I want to change the concept that Egypt is a cheap destination. Mm. It's an opportunity now to raise our prices. You know what? If you go into a store and you find the jacket that you're wearing sold for £10, you're not going to buy it. We want to change this concept. Cheap, there's a number of people around the world, they're afraid of cheap destination. I don't know what's going to happen to me. I know, I understand there is some people, they want to have numbers. Mm-hmm. We have to change and stop the concept. Some people are going to be mad at me.
But are they, I was just to say, like, how to secure that initiative?
I'll tell you. Mm. The all-inclusive. What is the all-inclusive? A passenger.